You can provision resources in AWS manually or with CloudFormation templates. So why would you want to use Terraform? Well, let me tell you why. When provisioning infrastructure resources in AWS, it can be a time-consuming manual process depending on how large your infrastructure needs to be. Most cloud providers allow for the creation and modification of infrastructure as code. AWS provides a service called CloudFormation, but if you use a multi-cloud approach, keeping up with code for provider-specific tools can be a pain. This is where Terraform can help. Terraform provides a common human-readable language for creating and managing infrastructure across multiple providers, making it your one-stop shop for your infrastructure as code needs. Are you ready to see just how easy it is to provision resources in your AWS environment with Terraform? Let's jump in.
All right, guys. I'm going to use VS Code to do this demonstration. This way we can look at our Terraform configuration nice and easily. And we also have the built-in terminal that we're going to use to run our commands. First thing I did was I created a directory called Terraform. This is my working directory where I'm going to store my Terraform files. If you look inside, I have a main.tf file, which is our main Terraform configuration. That is this code up here. In this code, we are deploying 3 app servers within our AWS environment. We're starting our Terraform configuration here. First thing we're doing is we are declaring our required providers. In this case, it's AWS. So we're using the AWS provider. The source is HashiCorp's AWS provider in the public provider registry. Next, we're specifying a version, which here we're doing 3.27. This operator here is actually a shorthand way of stating that we are allowing only patch releases within a specific minor release. So like I said, in this case, it's 3.27. Next, we are specifying the required version of Terraform, which is greater than or equal to 0.14.9. Next, we're declaring the provider specific values. Here we're setting the AWS region as US East 1. Profile, we're just using default. And then finally, we are declaring our resource within our resource block. We're creating 3 EC2 instances. We're using the count to specify how many of these instances we want to deploy. We're specifying our AMI for our image and our instance type, which we're using a T3 micro. And then we're specifying our tags down here. First, we're specifying a name, which we have long live the bat. And this expression here, we're basically going to designate the number of the instance and add it on to the end of our name. And then we're going to specify an environment that this is going to be in. So it's going to tag it as our dev environment. So pretty basic and simple configuration. I'm going to go ahead and clear my screen here. The first thing we're going to need to do before working with our Terraform configuration is we need to configure our AWS CLI to use our access key ID and our access key secret so we can communicate with our AWS environment. So if we do an AWS configure, it'll first ask us for our access key ID, which I'm going to go ahead and paste here. Enter. Now it's going to ask us for our secret access key. Go ahead and paste that here. And our default region is US East 1, which is the region that I want. So I'm going to hit enter. And then our default output format, we're just going to go ahead and accept the defaults. And now our AWS CLI is configured. So I'm going to go ahead and clear my screen. And now we can go ahead and I'm going to actually expand this so we can see our commands better. First thing we want to do is to check to make sure that our Terraform configuration is formatted correctly. There is a nice command that'll do this for you. Just run a Terraform FMT to format. If this comes up blank, that means your Terraform configuration is formatted correctly. If it lists out a file or multiple files, that means those files were reformatted correctly. Now, after we do our format, we now want to initialize our Terraform working directory. We'll do a Terraform init. And if it comes up all green like this, that means your working directory initialized successfully. Obviously, if it comes up red, it'll tell you the error that it ran into. I'll clear my screen. Now, if you want to validate your configuration to make sure that you're using the correct provider versions, or you know, you don't have any resource issues or general configuration issues, you can run a Terraform validate. which if it's successful, you'll get this message. If it's not, it'll give you an error message and it'll point you in the direction of what the problem is. So now that we know our Terraform configuration is correct and is valid, we can now do a dry run of the apply with the Terraform plan command. This will allow you to see what your configuration will do without actually making any changes. So we'll do a Terraform plan. We'll hit enter. It'll show you everything that it's adding. Nice thing about Terraform and its use of providers is if there are any dependencies or anything that are involved with what you're trying to create, it will add everything that is needed. So all of this will be added once we apply our configuration to our AWS environment. So let me go ahead and clear my screen, and we'll now run our Terraform apply command to apply our configuration. Hit enter. Here it shows you everything that the plan showed. Now it's asking if you want to perform these actions, and you type in yes. Hit enter and give it just a minute or two to run. And once it's complete, you'll get the green apply complete. It'll let you know how many resources you added, how many have been changed, and how many have been destroyed. Go ahead and clear my screen again. So to check to see what was added or changed, there's a couple commands you can use. You can do a Terraform show, which will show you everything that was deployed. Which is a lot of information here. You see, it breaks it down per app server. Let you know the state that it's in, it's running. There's our instance size, the tags that we added, so on and so forth. Lots of detail there. If you want to just see a list of resources that your Terraform configuration is responsible for, you can do a Terraform state list. And it shows the three app servers that we deployed to our AWS environment. Let me go ahead and move over here to my AWS console, and we can confirm here as well that our instances were created. See, our instances running are three. Here's our three instances. You can see the names with the number attached to the end. It's where our count expression came in. If I click on one of these to get more information, see here we have our two tags that we set, our name and our environment. So we have successfully provisioned three EC2 instances with just a simple configuration file and a few commands. As you can see, it's pretty fast and efficient and also very repeatable.
Now that was pretty simple, a good example of how Terraform can save you time. Let's say you were asked to create a dev, staging, and production environment in AWS. How would you do this? You could do it manually, but it would take a considerable amount of time. With Terraform, you could use the same configuration code and use some variables to swap out the environment names and deploy all three environments in a matter of minutes. Now what about deleting resources? Manually deleting resources can be a pain, especially when dealing with dependencies. Sometimes it can even take a while finding problem dependencies, blocking your deletion. But with Terraform, deleting dependencies is a much faster process.
So it's pretty easy to provision our infrastructure resources. It's just as easy to delete them. Now, say if you just wanted to delete one of our EC2 instances from our current configuration, you could do a Terraform destroy and use the target flag and then specify your resource that you wanted to destroy. In this case, we want to destroy all three instances, so we'll just use the Terraform destroy command by itself. So if I go ahead and hit enter, I'm going to go ahead and expand this so we can see a little bit better. As you can see, it is deleting all of the infrastructure that we have deployed. So just like the apply, it'll ask you if you want to destroy your resources. Type in yes, hit enter. We'll give it just a few seconds. And just like that, all of our resources have been destroyed. Go ahead and clear my screen. And if I do a Terraform show now, it should come up blank. Also, if I do a Terraform state list, now shows that there are no resources being managed by our configuration. And to go a step further to confirm, if we come back over here to our instances and we refresh, you can see that our instances are in a terminated state.
Wow, that was a breeze. Just like that, our infrastructure has been destroyed. So we're able to write our Terraform configuration to communicate with our AWS environment. We define the resources that we wanted to create. We used Terraform to check the format of our configuration, initialized our working directory, validated our configuration, then planned our deployment, and finally applied our configuration. Once we confirmed it created our infrastructure, we demonstrated how easy it is to then delete our infrastructure using the Terraform destroy command. As you can see, when dealing with provisioning and deleting resources in AWS, Terraform is a very useful tool that can make a cloud admin's job much easier and efficient. Maintaining your cloud infrastructure is a bit less time consuming. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Have a question? Let me know in the comments. Until next time, folks, keep being awesome.